Broadcasting from the Smart Mobility Summit 2019. Several thousand industry professionals gathered here in Tel Aviv these days. And here, behind the scenes, as a part of the EcoMotion community, GoTo is interviewing selected mobility professionals. My name is Katya Rosenauer, and now with me is Dr. Anat Bonstein, Chairman and Director of the Smart Mobility Initiative at the Prime Minister's Office. So you are the person actually who's organizing this event.
Almost. With a couple of other tens of people, yeah, and a great team, but yeah.
Yes, it's great to have you here and amazing work, and thanks so much for doing it for
all of us. Thank you so much for doing all of this also, being part of the community.
We're happy. Anat, before we begin the conversation, I want to play a little game with you about your life choices.
Okay.
So I'll ask very quickly, and you answer quickly too.
Okay.
So bike or car?
Bike.
Train or plane?
Train, easy.
I know that already. Swimming or running?
Running.
Car sharing or taxi?
Car sharing.
iPhone or Android?
Android.
Amazon or AliExpress?
Amazon.
Elevator or stairs?
Stairs, always, always.
Yeah?
I'm scared of elevators.
Oh, okay. That's a healthy fear.
Yeah.
Great. Anat, so let's talk a little bit about what's been happening during the summit and what are the main topics covered this year.
Okay, so this is the seventh summit. And during the last summit, the more focus was on the innovation, on the technology, on Israel being in the center of that, on a lot of people from around the world coming to the summit, which is still happening. But now the focus or the emphasis of the summit shifted towards what do we do with all this innovation. Now we're going to implementation phase. So it's about the shift that needs to be done regulatory-wise, policy-wise, readiness-wise, to have that shift from focusing on technology to focusing on implementation.
So basically before we were like working towards boosting the innovation, and now innovation is there.
Yeah.
And like, do you feel overwhelmed and like, oh my God, what have we done?
Every time I'm overwhelmed. I mean, as a government, we had a huge role, but it's not just us, it's everyone. I mean, when you see all those car manufacturers and all the investors here, all the venture arms of different automotive companies, it's also them doing it. And yes, the government played here a crucial role of actually saying this is a place, or this is something that I would really want to emphasize on, to focus on, and put a lot of money and effort and focus on. So the government did play a crucial role here in creating the ecosystem. And every time it excites me, you know, every time I'm excited about it.
But now let's talk a little bit about what's ahead of you now. So I imagine you had sessions on regulations and all the things that you listed. So like, what comes next? Tomorrow you come to work and then like you do what?
Well, the thing is that the summit brings a lot of people and delegation from across the world also to share information, because everything that we face around traffic jams and road congestion, reducing air pollution and road accidents is something that isn't limited to Israel. It's something globally. That's why everyone is meeting to talk about it. What we want to do is actually take this platform, use this platform of the summit as a place to actually share information, share knowledge, share challenges and opportunities. And from here, take it to real projects. Now we've been doing that. We've been working already with partners from Germany, from Singapore, from the U.S. on different projects that actually deploys technology, that deploys innovation. But still, it's the time to learn from one another, share the information, and see how we can leverage with that.
So can you talk a little bit about the things that you learned during these days? So for like something that was like eye-opening or something that, you know, confirmed your assumptions?
Well, you know, for instance, one of the panels was on data. Who should own the data? Data privacy, things like that. So that's one aspect. About the sharing mobility, how to make it something that doesn't come instead of public transportation, but but a side with it to make people use public transportation more and not less.
Tell me, do public transportation agents here in Israel feel threatened by all the micromobility activities or not?
No, because they like us also see it as something that is complementary to that. So it's the alternative mobility solutions will be more for first mile, last mile solutions, or where public transportation today isn't that doesn't, you know, have a strong a presence. So it's more of a complementary. So they also know that once those two are aligned together, more people will use public transportation.
Right. Tell me, what are the changes happening now in the public transportation section? I noticed there is the whole panel that was dedicated to electrification of transportation. So maybe a little more about that.
So we feel that the public, first of all, public transportation is a big user of oil, petroleum. So once you change a small amount, it's like the sector where you change a small amount of vehicles, you get a really huge impact.
Okay.
So that's what we're focusing on that. And now, once you shift X number of public transportation to cleaner energy, you get a real impact on reducing air pollution. And also, the public transportation is like the main, let's say, the middle of actually the whole smart mobility concept, like I said before. Adding to that, first mile solutions, last mile solutions, making it more of a clear move of different modes of transportation, that's where you're going to get the reduction of people saying, I don't want to take my car today. I know I can get from point A to point B in a seamless way.
Public transportation, I became a user relatively recently. I became a car sharing user first, and then naturally with that, I started to use more of public transport. But still, when I think about public transportation, I don't really think innovation. You know, I think of something, you know, that's been there for years, and you know, that kind of like it remains the same. Although the whole industry, all of a sudden, started to move and change. Like, can you talk a little bit about the changes that we should expect from the public transportation?
For instance, the innovation there doesn't have to be technological wise. It can also be concept wise. Think even of the simple thing of that people don't have to pay money now, don't need to come around, but a card, and can enter the bus with a card, not only in the front door, which makes such a long line, but in any doors of the bus. Something so easy, so simple, and that makes a much better flow of entering the bus and less time of the bus stopping at the bus station. Or for instance, once the bus will know if a bus station is empty and it doesn't have to stop there, then he won't stop there and won't waste time. So even simple things like that are algorithm based, but not a new technology of sensors or something like that, but algorithm based, could really, really enhance the flow of public transportation.
We're talking about small changes and big
that's
impact.
It. Exactly. Small changes, big impact. That was also the motto of our the National Plan for Smart Mobility. Yeah,
that's a good slogan.
Yeah.
Anat, I know you're going to be giving closing remarks today, so maybe you could share with us a piece of wisdom now before everybody else hears it.
Well, you know, I think my small piece of wisdom, if it's a piece of wisdom, was actually not in the closing, but more in the opening remarks. Where I'm saying, I think it's now all the innovation creators, they created innovation. Now we have a whole ecosystem of technology, innovation, of solutions. The thing is now the end users, it's the cities, it's the municipalities, the state, the neighbor, it's bringing those innovation now to the end user. And that's where we need to go now. And I think it's, again, not restricted to Israel. It's something globally that we should do it together and learn from each other. But the next phase is now not necessarily more innovation. It's taking the existing innovation, and there's a lot of it, and bring it to the street level.
Very down to earth, literally.
Literally down to earth.
Okay,
yeah.
That's amazing and very exciting work, and also very challenging ahead of all of us. Good luck with that. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
See you again.
Bye bye.